Thank you. test.
We all know that as President of the United States, Mr. Trump will continue his lifelong defense of the right of free speech in America. As a matter of fact, he supports the First Amendment just as much as he supports the Second Amendment. However, some people have taken advantage of Mr. Trump's hospitality by choosing to disrupt his rallies by using them as an opportunity to promote their own political messages. While they certainly have the right to free speech, this is a private event paid for by Mr. Trump. We have provided a safe protest area outside the venue for all protesters. If a protester starts demonstrating in the area around you, please do not touch or harm the protester. This is a peaceful rally. In order to notify the law enforcement officers of the location of the protester, please hold a rally sign over your head and start chanting, "Trump, Trump, Trump." Ask the people around you to do likewise until the officer removes the protester. Thank you for helping us make America great again.
I want you back again. I want your love again. I know you find it hard to reason with me, but this time is different. Darling, you're safe. You gotta tell me you're coming back to me. You gotta tell me you're coming back to me. You gotta tell me you're coming back to me. You gotta tell me.
I tried to tell you, but you didn't want to know. This time you're different, and determined to go.
Good evening, Washington State. Thank you for coming to greet the next President of the United States. You all have done such a good job. I understand they just can't get everybody out there in here quick enough, right? We still got six blocks of people trying to get in outside. I'm going to ask you a favor. It's really important, even if it's only a dollar, that you text 88022 and text the word donate. Whether it's a dollar or $5 or $10, the idea here is we want to show the world that Washington State supports Donald Trump. So even if you can only text the dollar, text it now, 80880, right? 88022, 88022, the word donate and put the amount, okay? Even if it's only a dollar, it's the amount of donors that's important, not the dollar amount. Because everybody that donates, even a little, is going to vote for Mr. Trump, right? Now, the other thing I need you to do for me is this. Mr. Trump and I have been talking in the back about winning Washington State, okay? Okay? I need your help to make my promise to Mr. Trump come true, because I promised him we'd win, okay? So this is what I need you to do. When you leave here tonight, there'll be people at the doors handing out voter registration forms. Now, I know there's a lot of people in this arena that may not even be registered yet, and I know you'll get registered, but by golly, those ballots mail out in the middle of October. And when they're mailed out, we want to mail to everybody that likes Donald Trump. So please, when you leave here, take voter registration forms. Make it your business to register 5 new voters next week. Okay? If everybody in this arena does that, there'll be 50,000 new voters for Donald Trump on Election Day. Right? That's how we're going to make Washington go red again. Get them registered to vote, right? Get them registered to vote. All right, we're a few minutes away from the main show. I'll tell you, Mr. Trump has brought 2 very special guests with him tonight. And that's because he loves you and loves the state of Washington so much. That's the reason he's back here, and that's the reason he's brought 2 special guests with him. So, ladies and gentlemen, in a few more minutes, we're going to try to give enough time for the rest of the folks to get in, or at least some of them, right? And then we'll go ahead and start the rally. But let Mr. Trump know you're out here, all right? Let him know.
your love again.
I know you find it hard to reason with me, but this time is different.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome RNC Chairman Reince Priebus.
There she stood in the street, smiling.
Thank you, Washington. Are you all ready to win? Are you ready to win? Are you ready to elect Donald Trump and Mike Pence President and Vice President of the United States? Well, I gotta tell you, working together, Donald Trump, the Republican Party, and all of you will help save America and get Donald Trump elected President of the United States, and we'll do it together. You know this. You agree. We're in a battle for freedom in this country. Do you agree we're in a battle for freedom? It's the same battle that founded this country. It's the same battle that James Madison reaffirmed in the Bill of Rights, and it's the same battle that we're here today. I don't know if any of you have been to the World War II Memorial in Washington, D.C. before, but like a lot of things, you get out of it what you're willing to put into it. And you walk around and you see all those great quotes from Nimitz and Eisenhower and those incredible heroes from that time. And then you walk up to that wall with those thousands of golden stars and you start to figure it out. That for every one of those golden stars, 100 little guys didn't come home to mom and dad. Donald Trump will fight for our freedom. Donald Trump will secure our southern border. Donald Trump will fight for a strong defense. He will fight for a conservative Supreme Court. And Donald Trump will make America great again. And in front of that wall, the World War II Memorial, it says, "Here we mark the price of freedom." We want to thank you all for being here. You know, we have a lot to fight for. This is an election about a choice. And while we know and we love, Donald Trump's not politically correct, but look at the choice we have. He's not. Look at the choice we have. Someone who tells it like it is and isn't politically correct, and Hillary Clinton, who lies with incredible skill and grace. She lies over and over and over and over again. Now we're going to beat her in November together, right? She lied when she said she turned over the email. She lied when she said that she provided everything to the FBI. She lied about the Clinton Foundation. She lied about Benghazi. And she lied over and over again. Here's the difference. Mike Pence and Donald Trump will tell you the truth. They'll protect our southern border. They'll protect our Second Amendment rights. They'll protect our vets and our military. And they will protect the sovereignty of the United States. Who here wants four more years of a Barack Obama-style government? Who here wants 4 years of Hillary Clinton in the White House? And the most important question, who's here to help save America and elect Donald Trump the next president of the United States? Thank you. We have another awesome guest that I don't know if you knew was going to be here. But he's one of the greatest mayors in America. He is our mayor. Please welcome an American hero, Mayor Rudy Giuliani.
I tell you, could you please get a little more excited? All right! Wow! Wow! Do you think in a million years Hillary Clinton could draw a crowd like this? This is the enthusiasm that's all around the country. I've traveled all around the country with Donald Trump, and what you see here tonight, with thousands of people still outside, thousands still outside. This is going on from coast to coast. You just heard our party chairman from Wisconsin. Did you know I'm from New York? And right after me is going to be Senator Sessions, the great senator from Alabama. Well, this is a movement. This is a movement that's going on all across the United States, and the reason is simple. We believe and we know that Donald Trump can change the direction of this country from the wrong direction to the right direction. You know that. I know that. The enthusiasm level for him is five times the enthusiasm level for Hillary, what's her name? And you can't measure that in polls. You can't measure that in polls. If we have a poll that's even, right? 45 her, 45 him, her 45 are voting for her like this. His 45 are voting for him with the enthusiasm that you have. The only way Hillary Clinton could get this kind of enthusiasm is if she got the Clinton Foundation to pay some people off to go to a rally. Did you ever believe she was as big a crook as she turns out to be? I didn't. 5 months ago, I appeared on the Hannity Show, and I pointed out 13 crimes she committed with the use of her emails. I keep adding to that list of crimes. I no longer have room on my phone, which I keep secure. And when I served in the Department of Justice for 17 years, a lot of it with Senator Sessions, I never once took a top secret piece of material out of my office. I stayed there until 4 in the morning and worked on it. I would never in a million years put top secret information on a private cell phone. She was found to be extremely careless by the director of the FBI. That was the nicest thing he could say about her. We are supposed to elect someone as President of the United States who has been proven to be extremely careless with our national security secrets. If I tried to hire her as an assistant U.S. attorney, I wouldn't be able to do it because she couldn't pass the background check. If you can't pass the background check to be an assistant U.S. attorney or an FBI agent, she's not going to pass the background test to be president because you're the ones who do that background test. Well, we all know what's wrong with Hillary Clinton. No reason for me to dwell on it any longer, because I'd be here for hours. Let me tell you what's right about Donald Trump. Donald Trump knows how to fix things. Donald Trump knows how to change things. Donald Trump is a man who looks at a problem, and what he says is, how can I solve it? How can I solve the problem of thousands and thousands and ultimately millions of people pouring into this country, creating a security risk of mass proportions and taking jobs away from Americans? He says to himself, how can I solve that problem? Not how do I fool you? How do I manipulate you? He doesn't talk in political bull you know what. He talks straight, he talks honest, and he tells you the truth. And he looks at the problem of immigration, and he says, how can I solve it? And he looks at the problem of jobs, that we don't have enough jobs in this country, that people aren't getting the raises they deserve, and they haven't been getting the raises they deserve for the last 10 years. He sees us losing jobs to China, to other countries with trade deals that were stupid, that trade deals where we gave away everything and we got nothing in return. He looks at that and he says, how can I solve it? Not for him, but for the American people, for you. He looks at the Middle East and he sees an Ayatollah who has threatened to destroy the state of Israel, an Ayatollah who continues to say death to Americans, an Ayatollah who's taking his boats and bringing them perilously close to our boats. You know why he's doing that? Because the Ayatollah knows he can push Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama all around the world, and they're not going to do anything about it. They drew too many red lines in the sand and threatened to do something and backed off for anyone to have any fear that they are going to act with force. You don't have to worry about Donald Trump. Nobody's going to push him around. And that means nobody is going to push the United States of America around. No more! No more! No more members of our military having to bow down and having pictures of that sent to us. No more! No more ransom. We don't pay ransom. That's what we have our special forces for. We go get our people out. And we don't leave them behind the way she did in Benghazi. Her gross negligence in securing that mission, her and Obama's failure to act swiftly and quickly and decisively, and I know something about how to run emergencies. I ran a heck of a lot of them in New York. If I ran one emergency in New York the way they ran Benghazi, they would have thrown me out of office. And in fact, if I did, I'd have been so embarrassed I would have resigned. So, you have a chance to elect someone who can change all that. You have a chance to say to the media, almost all of whom want Hillary, it is incredible. It's all part of the Washington insiders. Hillary, the Clinton Foundation, the State Department, pay for play, the newspapers, three terrible columns all made up about Trump, and then some pretty nice column about Hillary. But you can see through that, right? You can see through that, right through it. We're going to do what they did in England. We're going to do what they did in England when they decided to get out of the EU with Brexit. We're going to stand up for our independence. We're going to stand up for our rights. And we're going to elect Donald Trump and Mike Pence. Thank you and God bless you. And keep it up.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Senator Jeff Sessions.
Thank you all. What a fabulous rally this is. What a great crowd. Let me tell you, Hillary Clinton, Washington is coming for you this time. Rudy Giuliani is such a great guy, one of the most, I remember, don't you agree? New York City was in disarray. He was running for mayor. I'd known him. I'd served under him when he was associate attorney general, and I was a U.S. attorney in Alabama. And I told my wife, there's one man in America that can run New York City, and it's Rudy Giuliani, and he saved that city, really. American people are great people, good and decent people. They love their country. They're worried about their country. Poll after poll after poll shows that the American people believe we're on the wrong track. Do you believe we're on the wrong track? This country has got to make some changes. This is the last chance on a lot of critical issues for the future of this country. I know it and you know it. This election is going to determine our future in so many ways. So let me ask you, do you think Hillary Clinton even knows we're on the wrong track? Do you think Hillary Clinton has the will, the determination, the courage to stand up to the establishment, the special interest, and the forces that have been running this country and change it? Let me tell you, one man has that capability. One man has proven to us in these primaries that he has courage, he's got intelligence, he's got determination, he's got a strength about him, a willingness to challenge the establishment, to put this country on the right track again. And you know who that man is? Donald J. Trump. I tell you what, we love this country. I can tell this crowd does. And what we need is a man that can turn this country around and make America great again. This state is a great state. I'm happy to tell you, my daughter, her husband, and two grandchildren are down around Seattle, and we love this area, and we appreciate the hospitality. And Washington State has an opportunity this election to send a message throughout the country that we want to change, we want to make America great again, we're going to serve our country and deliver this election for Donald J. Trump. Thank you all. God bless you.
From Detroit down to Houston.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the next president of the United States, Mr. Donald J. Trump. Stand and say,
thank you, everybody. Thank you. Wow. Wow. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Unbelievable. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. I am thrilled to be back in Washington, state of Washington. Great, great, great people. Thank you very much. Thank you. I want to thank, if I could, because they work so hard. And, you know, outside right now, they have over 8,000 people trying to get in. And we set the record. I don't know how old this building is, but it's not brand new. And we set the record for attendance tonight. So I just want to thank you. Thank you very much. So they're going to be pouring in as we speak, unless you'd like me to come back in a half an hour and we'll start. No? No? All right. I want to thank Susan Hutchinson, who's in the audience someplace. Susan, done a great job. Brian Danzel. Where's Brian? Brian is over there someplace. I want to thank Don Benton, Senator Benton. He has been amazing. He said, you should come here. We'll fill that place up so fast, and he was right. So I want to thank Don and Doug Erickson, Senator Doug Erickson. So I want to thank all of them. Amazing. They've done an amazing job. We are going to work very hard over the next 70 days, and we're going to win this state, and we're going to win the White House. We are going to take back the White House. You know, a Republican would never come to the state of Washington. And you know, on television, they said, I wonder why he's going to the state of Washington. Because you know what? Republicans don't win it, but we're going to win it. That's why I'm here. That's why I'm here. And this love affair began about 3 months ago when I came up here, and we had record crowds. Two events, massive, massive crowds. And I said, why don't the Republicans win that state? I think we're going to win Washington State. So that's the story. That's why I'm here. That's why I'm here. And I don't know if you saw, but poll numbers came in today that are phenomenal. We're leading in Florida. We're leading in North Carolina. We're leading on a national basis in some of the polls. Los Angeles Times, we're 2 or 3 points up. We're doing really well, folks. I'll tell you what, it's all coming together. And when you see crowds like this, people fully understand why, I will tell you. Thank you. So we are going to have a great victory for the people. People. Remember, for the people. Going to be a victory for every citizen whose voice has not been heard. And that's a lot of people. It'll be a win for the voters, not the pundits, not the journalists. Not the lobbyists. Not the global special interests that take care of these politicians and get whatever they want. And they're the ones that are funding my opponent's campaign. Millions and millions and millions of dollars, and they have total control over crooked Hillary Clinton. Believe me. Total control. This is going to be your victory. It's going to be your victory. It's going to be your victory. True. We're going to create the new American future our children so desperately deserve. In this new future, millions of workers on the sidelines will be returned to the workforce. They've been taken out of the They are going to return, and they're going to return quickly, believe me. Crumbling roads and bridges and airports will be replaced with the infrastructure our country needs and deserves. Our infrastructure is going to hell. Frankly, I hate to say it, our country is going to hell, and we're not going to let it happen. Families trapped in welfare will be provided with jobs and opportunity.
government will become lean and mean, except it'll have a big, fat, beautiful heart. We will have an effective government, a responsible and honest government for a change. Our border will be protected. Our children will be safe. People don't talk about the inner cities, but I'm talking about the inner cities. They don't talk about the inner cities. The Democrats have taken advantage of African Americans. They take their vote, they win the election, and then they say, see you in 4 years. Thanks a lot. Not me. We will rebuild our inner cities and provide safety and peace to all of our citizens. American values and culture will be cherished and celebrated once again. But to achieve this future, we must break free from the bitter failures of the past, of which there have been many, and reject the same insiders telling us the same old lies, because they're lies. And I know these people well, believe me. One area where honesty is badly needed is on the subject of economic and living conditions for African-American citizens in the United States. Thank you. And thank you to law enforcement and our police. Thank you. Millions of African Americans in this country have succeeded greatly, and their contributions to every area of our life, and they have done so much. And now, throughout history, we should celebrate and cherish that success. But, this includes tremendous, tremendous and amazing achievements in art, science, sports, music, business, etc. It includes millions of African-American entrepreneurs, innovators, and the millions of African-American workers in our middle class. But, we must also talk about those who have been left behind. The millions suffering in disastrous conditions in so many of our inner cities and neighborhoods afflicted by total poverty, drugs, and horrible, horrible violence that we watch every single night. Every single night, you turn on the news and you see the violence, and it's horrible. No group in America has been more harmed by Hillary Clinton's policies and the policies of Democrats who have run our inner cities for literally 50, 70, 80, 90, even 100 years. Nobody has been hurt more than African Americans. There is no better evidence of the fact that Hillary Clinton's immigration policy, which brings in illegal immigrants and is that a true statement? It brings in illegal immigrants and refugees to take jobs from our hardworking African-American and Hispanic citizens, and they want those jobs. Instead of providing free health care and jobs to millions of refugees from around the world that we have no idea even where they come from, we should rebuild our inner cities and provide jobs to struggling Americans that have been struggling for years and years. Thank you. Tonight, I'm asking for the vote of every African-American and Hispanic citizen in this country who wants to see a better future, who wants to see real positive change. The inner cities of our country have been run by the Democratic machine for so long. These Democratic policies, the policies of Hillary Clinton, these Democratic policies, the policies of Hillary Clinton, have produced only poverty, joblessness, failing schools, broken homes, and rising crime. And it's only getting worse. They don't care about you. Remember that. They don't care about you. They want your vote, and they don't care. They've used you for decades and decades and decades, and they will continue to use you. Nearly 4 in 10 African-American children live in poverty. Think of that. 4 in 10 are living in poverty. This includes 45% of children under the age of 6. 58% of African-American youth are not working. Meanwhile, another 2 million Hispanic Americans have been added to the ranks of those in poverty since 2009, not a long time ago. In Detroit, half of all its residents do not work, half. In Milwaukee, where I just left, almost 4 in 10 African-American men between the ages of 24 and 54 do not have a job. Here, in the state of Washington, 65% of Latino children and 60% of African-American children live in low-income households. Chicago just had the most violent month in 20 years. More than 2,800 people have been shot in Chicago since just the beginning of the year. You look at war-torn countries are safer than living in our inner cities by a lot. It's not even close. It breaks everybody's heart. We cannot let this violence continue. We can't let it happen. It will and it must be ended. Under a Trump administration, it will indeed end. It will be my priority to work with communities, local police, state police, and federal law enforcement to dismantle the gangs and to liberate our citizens from violence and poverty and fear. I will appoint the best judges and prosecutors and federal investigators who will make this their personal mission. And so many people want to do that. There is one thing which can no longer be denied. If you keep voting for the same people, you will keep getting the same horrible results. Remember that. And Hillary Clinton has been doing this stuff for 35 years, and nothing's happened. Just remember, nothing's happened. To those suffering, I say, what do you have to lose by voting for Donald Trump? I will fix it. I will fix it. I will fight for you as no one ever has before. They don't fight for you. They don't fight for you. Let me also tell you what you have to gain. Jobs, opportunity, security, safety, great education, and many other things. Many, many other things. Thank you. This means very much and just so much to me. I believe every child in this country, in Detroit, in Baltimore, in Chicago, has the right to live out their lives in safety and in peace. In the Wall Street Journal today, Heather McDonald of Manhattan and the Manhattan Institute just wrote an important article about the soaring crime, and it is soaring like you've never seen before in our inner cities, and the responsibility of Democratic politicians for creating this horrible problem. Big article, highly, highly respected person. The article is called Black Lives Matter to Donald Trump. True. True. She writes that Mr. Trump's call to restore law and order recognizes the right of inner city residents to enjoy the same freedom from fear that the rest of America now really takes for granted. Freedom from violence is one of the greatest civil rights of our time. So too is the issue of school choice. What a difference it will make. What a difference it will make. We will fight for the right of parents to send their kids to the school that they believe gives their kids the best shot at success. I will not accept, and neither will you, a future in which children, and think of this, children of color, any color, in this country are not fully included in the American dream. Our whole country loses when we leave millions of talented, aspiring Americans on the sideline, which is happening all of the time. We want to give everyone a chance to contribute their full talents to our economy and to the greatness of our country. Remember, and most people don't know this, the Republican Party is the right? You know what I'm going to say, right? The Republican Party is the party of Abraham Lincoln. Not bad. Not bad. It's also the party of freedom, equality, and opportunity. People have forgotten it so long now. It is the Democratic Party that is the party of slavery, the party of Jim Crow, and the party of opposition. By the way, is there any place better to be than a Trump rally, right? Any place. Nothing makes me more honored and proud than to be the nominee of Abraham Lincoln's Republican Party, and we're going to do a job. Our party will fight to bring hope to every forgotten stretch of this country. Once again, we will be one American nation. One American nation. We will be one united people, and we will have one really great future again, believe me. And the great future will be built on these three critical words: jobs, jobs, jobs. This will include a complete revitalization of our manufacturing sector, which has been absolutely so badly hurt by Hillary Clinton's policies, so badly hurt, devastated. We're bringing jobs back to our country. We're not going to let people take our jobs anymore. We're not going to let our jobs go to other countries anymore. There will be retribution. There will be a price to pay. We are going to renegotiate the horrible NAFTA trade deal, probably the worst deal ever made in terms of trade. And we're going to keep out of the Trans-Pacific Partnership, a total disaster. And we're going to stand up to China and fight for every last American job. We're not going to be ripped off any longer. Thank you. The destruction that NAFTA started will be finished off if the Trans-Pacific Partnership is approved. It is a disaster for our country, a disaster for our workers. We won't let it happen. We cannot let it happen. These are very, very quiet protesters, I will say. I will say one thing. When Bernie Sanders had his protesters out, they had a lot more energy. They really did. Much better. They were much better. They felt it a little bit deeper in the heart. But that's just the beginning of what we're going to do for the American worker. On taxes, we're going to provide massive tax relief to all working people and lower the tax rate on small business from 35% to 15%. Low and middle-income parents will also be able to fully deduct the average cost of childcare from their taxes, a very important thing. On horrible, horrible regulations which are taking over our country, I'm going to direct every agency and department head in my government to identify all needless and job-killing regulations, and they will be removed. We will have a temporary moratorium on new regulations to allow our economy to grow. I mean, our economy is a disaster. To allow our economy to grow. Economic growth for last quarter has been revised downward to 1.1%, a number that you can't even imagine. Just so you know, if China goes to 7 or 8%, it's almost like a national catastrophe. And what they do is they devalue their currency, they do lots of other things, and they suck more blood out of our country, and we allow them to do it, folks. And they get back on track, and we keep going down. Not any longer. And believe me, we have the cards. They don't. We have the cards. We have all the cards. Meanwhile, our trade deficit in goods with the world is now nearly $800 billion. Think of that. Almost $800 billion trade deficit for the year. You really say to yourself, who negotiates these deals? I know. Political hacks and politicians negotiate them. No longer. We will further bring back our jobs by unleashing an American energy revolution, lifting restrictions on oil and coal and natural gas and all sources of American energy. This will create millions of jobs and lower the price of energy and your electric bill and every other bill for the American household. We are also going to secure our border and stop the drugs from pouring in and destroying our country. And I'll be talking about that tomorrow night in Arizona. Big speech on immigration. We'll be talking about that. Arizona, tomorrow night. The Seattle area recently experienced the largest number of heroin-related deaths. Think of it, in 20 years. The largest number in 20 years. It's getting worse. It's getting horrific, and not only heroin. They have drugs now pouring across the border that most people have never even heard of. We have to stop the drugs from poisoning our youth and poisoning our community. Additionally, we are going to stop the Syrian refugees from entering the United States and instead build a safe zone overseas. Amazingly, Hillary Clinton wants a 550% increase in Syrian refugees coming into our country. So, I thought I'd maybe do this if you'd like. You know, we talk about Syrian refugees, we talk about refugees, we talk about some people hate our values, hate our country, and I took something that was a song by Al Wilson, The Snake. Has anybody heard The Snake? Should I do it or not? You sure? Yeah? All right. So this really has to do with people coming into our country that can't be properly vetted. We have no idea where they're coming from. There's no paperwork. You know, our government says you have paperwork. There's no paperwork. And I believe in safe zones, and we have to help people out, and we have to have other people. You know, we're almost up to $20 trillion in debt. So we have to have other people, like the Gulf states, pay for it. It's called other people's money. But I believe very much that we have to help, and we'll build safe zones over in Syria, and we'll help the people. We have to do that. But if you look at what happens on a daily basis in Germany, what she's done to that country is unbelievable. If you look at what's happening in France, it's no longer France. Friends of mine that used to love to go to Paris, they say, we're not going to Paris anymore. It's no longer Paris. You see what's happening in different countries, and you see what's happening in our own country, whether it's Orlando or whether it's San Bernardino or whether it's any one of many different places. And I read this, and I said, it's so pertinent. It wasn't drawn for that reason, but I said, this really represents what it is when we allow people to pour into our country. We don't know who they are, but we know, we just know, bad things are going to happen. It's only a question of when. Bad, bad things are going to happen. So I'm going to read this to you. It's called The Snake. And a lot of people like it because it represents the truth. It represents what's going to be happening. This could be the great Trojan horse of all time. Did you see today where they announced tens of thousands of people coming in? And we have no idea even where they're being relocated. So, on her way to work one morning, down the path along the lake, a tender-hearted woman saw a poor, half-frozen snake. His pretty colored skin had been all frosted with the dew. Oh, well, she cried, I'll take you in, and I'll take care of you. Take me in, oh, tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh, tender woman, sighed the broken snake. She wrapped him up all cozy in a curvature of silk, and then laid him by the fireside with some honey and some milk. Now she hurried home from work that night. As soon as she arrived, she found that pretty snake she'd taken in had been revived. Take me in, oh tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh tender woman, sighed the broken snake. Now she clutched him to her bosom. You're so beautiful, she cried. But if I hadn't brought you in by now, you simply would have died. Now she stroked his pretty skin, and then she kissed him and held him tight. But instead of saying thank you, that snake gave her a vicious bite. Take me in, oh tender woman. Take me in, for heaven's sake. Take me in, oh tender woman, sighed the vicious snake. I saved you, cried the woman, and you bit me, heavens why. You know your bite is poisonous, and now I'm going to die. Oh, shut up, silly woman. Said the reptile with a grin, you knew damn well I was a snake before you took me in. Get ready, folks. Not going to be pretty. Going to be a bad deal going on. Bad, bad deal. And I just thought that was very representative of what's going to be happening. Not good. Remember, I said it. Now, if on November 8th you go and you vote for Donald Trump for president, you can forget about it because it's not going to happen. We're not taking him in. We're not taking him in. Thank you. Thank you very much. Another major issue in this race is foreign policy. Hillary Clinton has made one bad foreign policy decision after another, beginning with the support for going into the war in Iraq in the first place, which, by the way, I opposed. Her tenure as Secretary of State may be regarded as the most disastrous such tenure in United States history. She was horrible, horrible. Look at the world before and after she became Secretary of State. Pre-Hillary, in early 2009, Iraq was seeing a reduction in violence, Libya was stable, Syria was under control, the group we now know as ISIS was close to being extinguished, Iran was being choked by sanctions, right? Right? Now, fast forward to the present time, after Hillary. Here is what it looks like. Iraq is in total chaos. Syria is in the midst of a disastrous civil war and a refugee crisis that now threatens Europe and the United States. ISIS has been unleashed onto the world viciously. Iran, the world's top state sponsor of terrorism, has been put on a path to nuclear weapons and was given a $400 million cash ransom payment. And that's not to mention the $150 billion that they're getting back. This is the legacy of Hillary Clinton. Death, destruction, terrorism, and weakness. America deserves a better legacy. All of you deserve a better future and a country that runs so much smarter. I am the change agent. This is a movement. No matter where we go, anywhere in this country, we have crowds like this. We have people that love our country. They want to see our country heal. They want to see our country be smart. They want to see our country get better. Hillary Clinton is the defender of the status quo. While our country lost badly under Hillary Clinton, she cashed in big time, made a lot of money. Bill Clinton's speaking fees surged while Hillary was Secretary of State. Bill was paid almost $50 million for speeches during her tenure, an increase of 44% over the previous years. Then there was all of the money funneled into the Clinton Foundation from foreign governments and corporations. It was pure and simple, pay for play. Just look at what she did with UBS, the big banking concern, or Russian uranium. A disaster relief in Haiti. Haiti has been a catastrophe. And the money that was spent and the money that was missing, unbelievable. And so many other examples. But the only way to learn the full depth of her public corruption is to read the 33,000 emails that she deleted. They're gone.
It's very sad.
And not only deleted, folks, this was after she was subpoenaed by Congress to produce. And not only that, she bleached, which somebody said they never even heard of, in a very expensive fashion, used chemical so that nobody will ever be able to see him. Who does this? Who does this? Hillary Clinton said under oath that she turned over all of her work-related emails. But we now know that is just one more Clinton lie. The FBI found thousands of work-related emails she never turned over, and then another 15,000 emails were just discovered a few weeks ago. Now, today, another 30 emails were discovered by the State Department that Hillary Clinton failed to turn over. These were emails about Benghazi. It just never ends with the Clintons. There's only one way to get justice in this totally rigged system. And it's a rigged system when they did nothing about the crimes that she committed. It's a rigged system. Remember that. The only justice we're going to get is a tremendous victory for everybody in this room and this nation on November 8th. A big, big vote. Thank you. Thank you. In a Trump administration, the State Department will work for the country, not for Hillary Clinton's donors and special interests. Under Hillary Clinton, it's the powerful protecting the powerful, politicians defending politicians, insiders fighting for insiders. I'm fighting for you. That I can tell you. I'm fighting for you. The government will work for citizens once again. The era of division will be replaced with a future of total unity. We'll love each other as a country again. We're going to do it by emphasizing what we all have in common. We will proudly promote our culture as Americans, the best anywhere in the world. It's time to break with the failures of the past and fight for every last child in this country to have a better future and a future that they deserve. So this is the change that I'm promising all of you. An honest government, a thriving economy, a just society for each and every American, and jobs, lots of jobs. I'm asking for your vote so I can be your champion in the White House. Together, we will make America wealthy again. Together, we will make America strong again. We will fix our depleted military, and we will take care of our vets. We will appoint the proper judges to the United States Supreme Court. We will protect and save our beautiful Second Amendment. We will repeal and replace the horror known as Obamacare. We will make America proud again. We will make America safe again. We will make America great again. God bless you. Good night. Thank you.